Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the valence bond theory, and in that case we have discussed about that how the atomic orbitals they combine with each other so as to form a bond. So depending on that only we are going to talk about that is what is the type of overlapping that we could see in during a formation of overlapping of atomic orbitals. So let us talk about it. So during a formation of a covalent bond, basically there are three kinds of overlapping that we could see for the atomic orbitals, and those are basically SS overlapping, the second is PP overlapping, and the last one is basically SP overlapping. So at least these are the things that we are going to talk about whenever a covalent bond has been formed. So talking about the first one, that is SS overlapping. So let me discuss it with the help of an example. As the name suggests, that is, it is very much easy to understand that is SS overlapping is nothing but the overlapping of the atomic orbitals, and that atomic orbital should be S orbital. So overlapping of two S orbital of the different atoms to form a covalent bond is basically known as SS overlapping, and that is what I am going to discuss about. So for example, if you take hydrogen molecule and talk about the hydrogen, hydrogen is the one which has an atomic number of 1, so therefore we could write it as 1s1. So the orbital which consists of basically one electron. But talking about the another hydrogen, so this is the another hydrogen that I am talking about. So again, it will have an atomic number of 1, so therefore I could write it as 1s1. So therefore the atomic orbital could be represented with its one electron. So this is the one which is S orbital, and again this is the one which is S orbital which consists of basically unpaired electron, and they both will pair with each other. So since talking about the S orbital, S orbitals are basically the one which are spherical in shape, and they don't have any kind of direction, we could say. So therefore we could say that is the structure of the S orbital will be this. So this is the spherical one that I'm making, and this is the one which consists of electron, and that also with positive spin, suppose. But talking about the another one, that is this one. So this is the one which will have basically negative spin, suppose, because obviously whenever they will combine with each other, and according to valence bond theory we have discussed that during the combination the both of the electron, both the unpaired electrons will have opposite spin. So this is the two hydrogen atom, and this is the hydrogen atom that we have, and again this is the hydrogen atom that we have, and the both are having S orbital. So this S orbital which is of spherical shape, and they will combine with each other in such a manner that we could see that this hydrogen atom which consisted of one electron that is moving, having a positive spin, while this another hydrogen atom which has an electron of opposite spin. So now they will combine with each other, and that is how we could see that the two S orbitals, they are combining with each other, and that's the case that we could see. This is an example of SS overlapping of atomic orbital, and that is how the hydrogen and hydrogen bond has been formed. So this was an example of SS overlapping, and now let us talk about and it is not necessary that only the hydrogen is the one that will form SS overlapping. There are also several molecules that are being capable of forming the single bond between the two atoms, and this was one of those examples. And talking about the another one, that is now I am going to talk about that is PP overlapping. So as the name suggests, that it is nothing but the overlapping of the two p orbitals of the different atoms. So p orbitals of the different atoms, so therefore they will combine with each other so as to form a single bond, a single covalent bond, if you could say. Talking about that of fluorine, so suppose this is the example that I'm talking about. So fluorine has an atomic number of 9, so I could represent it by 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. So this has the valence electron of 5, but formation of bond doesn't depend on the valence electron, it depends on the valency. So in this case we know that the fluorine is the one which is required one electron so as to get a complete octet, and that is how we could say that one electron is been needed to this fluorine. I suppose if I am talking about another fluorine which is also having electronic configuration, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. So suppose if fluorine is combined with that of fluorine so as to form a molecule, that is F2, obviously the sharing of electron will take place because in this case, the both the fluorine needs electrons so as to complete its octet, and that is how the overlapping concept is the what that we are going to focus on. And since we are talking about fluorine is the one which is belonging to P block, and we could see that its outermost subshell is basically 2p, and that consists of basically three orbitals, 3p orbitals, and here also we could see 3p orbitals, and this one consists of basically 5 electrons, so therefore 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons with one electron that has been left unpaired. I'll talk about this one also, again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons with one electron remains unpaired. So now this unpaired electrons are the one that are responsible for formation of bond, and while these two are not they will not form bond, only the one which is here they will form bond. So talking about the p orbital, and let me talk about the structure also. So p orbitals are the one basically they have basically dumbbell shape structure, and so therefore we could write for particularly for px, because there are three orbitals px, py and pz. So suppose if I consider the px to be the one which is having an x-axis, because they have particular direction, and talking about the py orbital, so suppose if it has y-axis, so suppose if I am mentioning it this way, so this is py, and talking about pz is the one which is z-axis, as we know, but I cannot draw it on a 2D, 2D page, obviously I am representing it with this one. So this is basically pz orbital. So if you observe this one, that is, so among this orbital, one will be px, one will be py, and one will be pz. Here also px, py, and pz. So in this case, you could see that the pz orbitals are the one which are having unpaired electrons, and that's the reason that both the cases, pz orbitals will be remaining, will be responsible for formation of a bond, and that is how we could see the bond formation in such a way that, let me tell you. So because we are talking about pz, so because it is an axis we are talking about, so axis other that could be drawn, since we are talking about all the orbitals, so therefore the p orbital will consist of basically this one is, this could be written as px, py, and this one is pz, and basically the three are basically mutually perpendicular to each other, and this is the one that I am talking about, one fluorine, that is atom, that is fluorine, and which consists of one electron in its outermost orbital, you could say in that manner. And talking about the another one, so another one will also have the same thing, so even that will have that is one would be px, this one would be py, and this one would be suppose pz. So even the pz consists of one electron, and now they will have an opposite spin like this way, and this is how the fluorine will combine with that of the another fluorine, and that is how the bond between them it is formed. So this is because of the F2 molecule that we have taken an example, and this is how we could have explained about the PP overlapping. So this is how the overlapping takes place over here, and the last one is remaining, and that is of the SP overlapping. So let me talk about that also. So now we are discussing about SP overlapping. And obviously, this is very simple to understand, that it is the overlapping of the two atomic orbitals. One will be of S and one will be of P, of the two different atoms, and they will combine with each other, and so as to form a single covalent bond. And this is how the interaction takes place. So let me give you an example in this case. That is, as we have discussed earlier only, that is in SS and in PP overlapping, they have a particular shape. So now let us come back to that. Directly that we could say that is what is the overlapping that it occurs. So let me give an example like that of HCl or HF suppose. So how the interaction takes place in this case? So since we are talking about hydrogen, hydrogen is the one which consists of basically one electron, and the atomic orbital can be represented with only one orbital having one electron. While talking about the fluorine, fluorine is the one which is consists of 9 electrons, and the electronic configuration, according to that, we could write it in this way, and Since we are concerned with basically, we are concerned with the unpaired electrons. So this is the orbital that we could see for P, and this is how we are filling the electrons and having that is one unpaired electron here. So here it is one unpaired electron for hydrogen and one unpaired electron from fluorine. Now they will be both be responsible for formation of a bond, and the energy level of the s orbital and p orbital are almost the same. That is the reason that they are forming bond. And let us take an example with the help of a diagram, then we could be able to understand it in a better way. So now talking about the s orbital. S orbital is basically of spherical shape. So this is what I'm talking about, the hydrogen, and it will have suppose a positive spin like this one. So this is what I have represented for hydrogen, and it will have also it will have an axis like xz, but it's of no use because it's a non-directional orbital. And talking about the next one, that is f orbit f fluorine, the orbital of that is p orbital. So in that case we could see that pz orbital is responsible for formation of bond. So either I could write it in this way, that is so this is the pz orbital. While talking about the rest, which are not been able to form the bonding with hydrogen, and those are basically this one would be suppose px, while the other one would be suppose py. So this is the pz orbital of fluorine, and this is basically the s orbital of hydrogen. So now they both will combine with each other, but we have saw that even one electron, unpaired electron, has been present in the p orbital of fluorine. So therefore this is the one, and now they both will have opposite spin, and that is how the bond will take space. And this is what I want to talk about. So this was an example of an sp overlapping, and there are also various kind of examples that we could observe. And so that's it, this is what I wanted to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood that is how the overlapping takes place and what are the types of overlapping, and so as to form a covalent bond. So I hope you will share this video with the friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much.